Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys, we're from Group 6 and we will explain about our materials of this presentation. Thank you for the time for Mr. Mofit as a lecturer of pest management technology and all of you guys. Before we start, please let's introduce ourselves. First, my name is Lingga Darmaya Putri with study number 126.
My name is Sita Husna Berliana Hapsari with student number 116.
My name is Melinda Wijayanti with study number 128.
Okay, let's move on to explain our material. A. Relationship between sampling and monitoring programs as the basis for pest control decision. Monitoring is an important activity in making every pest control decision in pest management activities. The relationship between the level of decision making and monitoring activities is very closely related because the economic threshold value and control threshold that are set will be meaningless if there is not accurate and reliable data. This data is generally obtained from monitoring or monitoring activities. The relationship between sampling and monitoring program is an observation method that is simple, easy to operate, does not require a long time, and does not require expensive equipment and material. The population of organism is definite as the number of all individual organisms present in a place at a certain time. Observation only use a small part of the population, called the sample, to estimate the true nature of the population. Problem in sampling. In sampling, the method of determining the sample must be precise and can be represent the population so that the result of calculation on the sample can be used to approximate the nature of the actual population. When we take sampling who not represent one population, we must retake sampling who must be represent that population for the result conclusion are because when we not take sampling represent one population, the result and conclusion are not correct and decision about control measure will be detrimental. Sampling method requirements. First, the result of observation must be trust. This method will be produced data that can represent or correctly describe the nature of the real population. And second, practical. The observation method carried out must be simple, easy to do, and does not require expensive equipment and material, and does not take a long time. Next.
Okay, next we talk about various sampling method. Sampling method is a method of technique of obtaining data on the observed insect population density. Not all data from sampling can be in the form of population density per unit of land surface, but in the form of other approaches. Three main sampling method, namely the absolute method, the relative method, and the population index. First, we talk about absolute method. The absolute method produces population estimate in the form of the number of individuals, unit length, surface, or insect habitat observed. Can be used for estimating population density in a particular observation area. The absolute method is the best because it has high accuracy. It is recommended for ecological research as well as controlling decision making. For disadvantage, it takes a lot of money, time and effort, especially for the extraction of collected insects. For two, we talk about relative method. The relative method produces population estimator that are difficult to convert in terms that affect the estimator. Samples were obtaining using insect traps, such a light trap or pitfall trap, and swing nets. Okay, for next, we talk about population index method. In the population index method, the observer only count or measure that insect leave behind, namely their cropping, cocoon, nets, and plant damage. For example, the observation of breadbasts, which is then counted the number of burrow, the population index that is most often used is the damage or is the result of pest attack that occur on the affected plants, namely the intensity of the damage or the extent of the attacks.
Okay, we will talk about factors that cause sampling error. First, the nature and skill of the observers. In the pest monitoring programs, of course, need many pest observers and farmers who have a variety of trade, knowledge, and skill. It will affect the quality of the data that will be collected and the occurrence of errors that cannot be avoided. In order to minimize this error, before carrying out the observation activities, it's better to provide special education and training for farmers and observers on how one should properly observe pests. In addition, another way to overcome the error of this factor is to create a manual for standardization of observation tables that is clear and easy to use by observer or farmers. Second, local environmental condition. Local environmental condition also affect every insect activity and behavior observed. Many types of insects are active during the day, at night, even active at certain hours. In this case, effort to reduce error in sampling by means of sampling must be adjusted to the rhythm of insect life or pest behavior. There are also other environmental conditions such as rainfall, wetness, temperature, soil, and also the way of farming that may affect insect activity. 3. The special nature and distribution of insects. Observers have the assumption that insects are spread evenly in all area or plot of observation. So, the number of sample units observed is quite small because it's considered to be able to describe the nature of the population in all this field. But the reality in the field actually show that the tendency of the distribution of insects is in group or in group. In determining the sampling method, there are three common characteristics. First, regular or average distribution. In this form of regular distribution, the population density of insect pests is almost uniform. Therefore, the result of observation of population density in each sample unit will be relatively the same. The form of a regular distribution of mathematics will be characterized by the magnitude of the value of diversity will be smaller than the average. Second, random distribution. In this form, the position of an individual insect pest at one point in the space is not affect and does not affect the position of other insect pests found at another point. In another word, the position of individual insect pests at one point in the space is free and not affected by another insect pest. Lastly, cluster distribution. In this form, the position of an individual insect pest at one point in the space will be influenced and affect the position of other insect pests found at another point. In other words, the position of the other insect pests will affect each other.
Thank you for Thank you for your attention. This is our material. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.